B5101 butterfly valve assembled to a stainless steel vertical canister actuator. Secure the valve with the stem facing up. Using an open-ended wrench and hex key, remove the two top body bolts and both nylock nuts. Assemble the coupler and the split pin. Slide the coupler over the actuator shaft. Slide the split pin through the hole. Using a punch, a hammer, and a hard surface, secure the split pin in both sides of the coupler. Assemble the actuator brackets to the actuator body. Using a bolt, lock washer, and flat washer, thread the bolt in loosely through the slotted portion of the bracket, making sure the bracket can still move freely. Repeat for the other bracket half. Both brackets must move freely. When installing the indicator arrow, the flat portion of the arrow must face away from the actuator and towards the bolt for normally closed. Push the indicator down far enough to cover the split pin. Close the brackets and flip the actuator over. Lay the actuator cap on top of the actuator and secure with a 90 degree air fitting. Tighten with a wrench until the top cap stops spinning. Place the actuator and bracket assembly on top of the valve by lining up the coupler to the stem and the holes on the bracket to the holes on the body. Using a bolt 5 millimeters longer than the original body bolts, assemble the actuator brackets to the valve body. Assemble nylock nuts to the body bolts and tighten both securely. Make sure the actuator body bolts are still loose. Apply 80 psi compressed air to the air fitting. At this point, the valve will open and the actuator will turn. Now is the time to tighten both actuator bolts securely. At this point, exhaust the air supply and check the disc to make sure it is closed properly. This actuator can be used on 1/2 inch to 4 inch butterfly valves.